stick to that.
I mean, I suppose the first thing, Paul, is how do you get started?
I'm completely unqualified and was more or less unemployed in the mid-70s and answered an ad in Time Out for a job as an assistant manager at the Gate Cinema, which I didn't get. But they called me back the next week and said, do you want to be our dispatch clerk? We have a little distribution company, Cinegate Limited, which worked out of the basement of the Gate Cinema. And my job was to check the films to see if they were clean and that all the sprockets were okay and send them out to film societies. So that's how I got into film, and that's kind of how I got to love film as well. The area I'm most comfortable with is drama. I work in the art house crossover world, which in the present world is severely under threat. It's the kind of movies I've historically made are very, very difficult to make now because of the primacy of television. Any producer going into the business these days should, and director, should be thinking about TV as much as they're thinking about film. If you look at Breaking Bad or True Detective or The Sopranos even, they're basically enormous movies because the difference, the distinction between the two is collapsing.
What is the first thing you want to see in a director that comes to you and asks for financing his project?
That's a very good question. I would think understanding of the script. Understanding of the script, yeah. A kind of real deep understanding of the material.
You seem to be quite often getting into the kind of projects that you have no previous experience with. Where do you get the courage?
You know, I'm an opportunist, so usually I can see how to make a film, and I'm right some of the time and I'm wrong some of the time, but I wouldn't say it's courage. I think it's kind of, it's stubbornness, opportunism and bloody mindedness to say I'm going to get this done come what may, but always with a kind of pragmatic eye on I'm not a person who mortgages his house or uses his own money. You know, first lesson is never use your own money, unless you're making a film on your iPhone. Never use your own money, never lose your own money. Because the very fact that somebody's giving you money means that there's some confirmation in the world that somebody else is as interested in your idea as you are.